各位同事早晨。
Members, good morning. We have formed a quorum and it's also the appointed time. May I call to order meeting of the Subcommittee on Peak Tramway Safety Amendment Regulation 2018 Commencement Notice. We'll first proceed to elect chairman of the Subcommittee. According to our house rules, I invite nominations now. A valid nomination has to be made verbally by a member and also seconded by at least one other member and with the consent of the member being nominated. Mr. Ronick Chen, I nominate you, Mr. Chan Kim Po, to be the chairman. Any seconder, please? Mr. Yu Siu Wing, seconded. All right, I accept the nomination. Any other nominations, please? I apologize. Mr. Yu, can you please take the chair? Any other nominations? No. Then Mr. Chan Kim Po elected. All right. Do we want to elect a deputy chairman? Not necessary. All right. Then please invite the administration to join us. Please refer to the seating plan for the list of officials present. And I will first give the floor to the administration to brief us on the bill, and then I will open the floor to members for questions. Thank you, Chair, and good morning, members. On the 9th of July this year, the administration gazetted the Peak Tram Safety Amendment Regulation 2018 Commencement Notice. The Secretary for Commerce and Economic Development designated 17th December that the capacity of tram cars will be increased from 120 to 210. The commencement date is the 17th of December, and in November and October respectively, 2018, the LegCo was briefed on the detailed plan to enhance our peak tramways, and also the amendment regulation to increase the tram car capacity from 120 passengers to 20 and 10 passengers. There was no objection, and it was decided that the Secretary for Commerce and Economic Development would, by notice and a gazette, the commencement date of the regulation. If members have no questions, I'll give the floor to the Peak Tramways Company to brief you on the details of the upgrade project. Yes, Mr. Martin Sawyer.
Good morning. Thank you very much for inviting us to the meeting today. Maybe I can start by reminding everyone why we needed to upgrade the Peak Tram. Prior to 2019, we had very long queues forming outside the Peak Tram termini on most weekends and certainly public holidays. There were very long waiting times for passengers, up to 2 hours during busy holiday periods and in all types of weather. In 2018, we transported 6.5 million people on the peak tram. So our peak tram upgrade will increase the capacity by 75% from 120 to 210 passengers per trip. It'll reduce waiting times by well over 70%. We'll completely remove the queues from the public areas outside the lower and upper termini. We'll provide covered, temperature-controlled waiting areas for up to 1,300 people at the lower terminus. We'll provide improved peak tram access for persons with disabilities, and we will significantly enhance the image of the peak tram as one of Hong Kong's most important tourism icons. We have invested more than 700 million Hong Kong dollars in this project. The fifth generation tram car, the one that we've just taken out of service, was 18.7 meters long and carried 120 passengers. The new tram car will be 33 meters long with capacity for 210 passengers. As we previously presented, we are improving every aspect of the journey, from arrival at the terminus to alighting at the peak. If you look at the plan that's on the screen, the arrival will be much more open and will feature a significant piece of public art. There will be an extensive and fascinating historical gallery to entertain our guests while they are queuing for tickets. And then they will move, after purchasing tickets, into a multimedia entertainment experience. Once that is complete, they will move up travelators up to the new platforms, where they will get the first glimpse of the new peak tram. We are undergoing a total system and infrastructure upgrade with new haulage system and ropes, strengthened track and bridges, and new stronger rails. We have planned significant improvements to access for persons with disabilities. The new tram cars will have wider doors, which will allow roll on and roll off at all eight doors, with wheelchair fixings at each gangway. We will install a wheelchair lifting platform. We'll provide access ramps from the tramway path to boarding and alighting platforms, and we'll have access paths from the main entrance. Hong Kong said farewell to the fifth generation of tram cars on the 27th of June this year, with a very positive public and media response and an excellent turnout of local visitors for the last month. One of the fifth generation tram cars was removed on the morning of the 28th of June, 2021. The haulage equipment has now been removed from the peak tower haulage room, including haulage drum, gearbox and motors, and deflection sheaves. Our team are in the final stages of removing old rails, and new rails are now being laid on the track. We have undertaken extensive demolition, and construction works are ongoing at the former lower terminus and at the transit area, the lower terminus, and the main entrance. Our new tram cars were built and tested in Switzerland and are now being shipped to Hong Kong. They went through the Suez Canal on the 9th of August and are currently sitting outside Djibouti. The new haulage equipment, which you can see is massive, was built and tested in Europe and has been delivered to Hong Kong. We are now in our final phase and include lower terminus expansion and refurbishment, upper terminus structural alterations and refurbishment, remaining strengthening of the bridges and slopes, strengthening of the covered nullah under the lower terminus transit area, replacement of all the rails, pulleys and sleepers, installation of haulage equipment, ropes, control and signalling system. Then we will install the new tram cars which will be tested and commissioned, and the staff will undergo extensive training. We commenced the construction of this project in December 2018 and held our first tram suspension between the 23rd of April and the 22nd of July of 2019. The second suspension, as I've said, commenced on the 28th of June, and our target completion is late December this year. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much. 跟住呢，我係請委員注意呢。
Now, members, please note that LegCo set up a subcommittee to study the peak tramway safety amendment regulation, and the purpose was to consider the amendment to the definition of tram car and also the proposal to increase the capacity of a tram car from 120 passengers to 20 and 10 passengers. Members may refer to the report of the subcommittee for details. All right, I open the floor to members for questions. Mr. Ronick Chen, thank you. As said by Mr. Sawyer, the peak tram is iconic public transport for Hong Kong, so I fully support the current program. Now, according to the paper, the total cost for the upgrade project was $650 million, but we were told at the presentation just now that it was $700 million. I'd like to know whether $700 million would include everything and then no more facilities will have to be added. And secondly, apart from the investment by the Peak Tramways Company of $700 million, I'd like to know whether the administration has invested resources to dovetail with the current project. Since the outbreak of the pandemic, we have seen tourists plummeting. So now I believe you have taken out financing from the banks. I'd like to know whether the current situation has impacted on your financing plan, leading to a slippage in the project. Now, I'd like to know whether the peak tram tickets will be adjusted. I'd like to know when the system reopens, or what will be the level of fares? Thank you. I'll take the second question first, and then I will defer to the company for the first and third questions. Thank you. The Peak Tramways companies will fully fund the whole upgrade project. There is no need for the government to spend public money on the project. So, whether $700 million is sufficient and what is included, I will defer to Mr. Sawyer later. As regards the level of fares, since 1986, the fares of peak tram is no longer regulated by law. So I will defer to Mr. Sawyer as well. Thank you, Mr. Sawyer.
Thank you for the question. If I can respond firstly on the investment, in the presentation I said over $700 million, and we are still making sure that we're fully funding the project. Once we have complete, as I say, our target is the end of the year, there will be no further work required apart from obviously the ongoing maintenance of the tracks, the trams, the slopes, and all of the things that we have to do on an annual basis anyway. But our investment, as I say, will be definitely in excess of $700 million, but will cover the whole project. In terms of project slippage, I think there was a question on project slippage. The project has slipped. COVID has, along with every other business in the world, has affected us significantly. It's affected the suppliers, our supply chain, the manufacturer of the trams, the manufacturer of the equipment. So, yes, that's definitely affected it, and yes, that's cost us more money for the project. In terms of tickets, obviously, as a commercial business, we look at all of the factors involved in the prices that we set for the peak tram. We look at the market outlook, we look at our profit expectations, our expenses and our investments when we're planning that fee structure. We don't have a number today, but as a commercial business, we believe that our customers will reflect on any service that doesn't provide value for money and will vote with their feet. So there was a comment earlier that full support for this project was given, which is much appreciated. The comment was also mentioned public transport, and the peak tram is not public transport. It's recreational. It's a tourist facility. And so we set fares in a commercial marketplace, looking at the competition as well. Thank you.
Next, Mr. Yu Siwing. For this plan, I think the public would generally be in support, and tourism industries would be in support of the plan as well. Just several questions. First, according to your plan, you have 1,300 waiting area. So for this waiting area compared to the one before, is it sufficient? Because you have over 1,300 kind of area reserved, so would that be sufficient? And second, there were some special assets for tourists, for group of tourists. Will there be the same area in the new facilities? Third, so when they arrive at the peak, will there be some ancillary facilities so that it wouldn't only be well-furnished downhill, but also at the peak, it would deliver the same standards as well? And about the taxi problems, you know, there are illegal taxis waiting for customers downhill. So I don't know if the government or the PTC have any measures in place to prevent the tourists from being disturbed by the illegal taxis, so would jeopardize whatever efforts that the PTC is making. Fifth question. As the PTC has said, it's a commercial project, it's a tourism project. So after the new facilities come into fruition, would the government provide more promotion for this over 100-year-old tourist attraction? So will the government do more on this, on promoting the new peak tram? And sixth, about the old peak trams, many citizens may see it with historical value, so would it be preserved? So I would first answer the question about the old peak trams, the used peak trams, and the illegal taxis. And as for the capacity of the peak tram, I would direct it to Mr. Sawyer. So I would answer the questions about illegal taxis first. We have been doing whatever we can to curb the problem of illegal taxis. We know that for Garden Row, about near the peak tram terminus, police are patrolling, and they are using the undercover operations to curb those activities there. So we would be continuing our efforts in curbing the illegal taxis. And about the old peak tram, the fourth generation of peak trams, as you may notice, we have already placed it at the peak in tourist center for exhibition. And for the fifth generation of peak tram, we are considering to place it somewhere. Is that, let me confirm. Maybe I would direct it to the PTC about the used fifth generation of peak tram. And about the promotion, The Tourism Board, we have been working hand in hand with the PTC, as we have always done, as a partner to help promote the peak tram. And of course, after this whole overhaul, we would have more promotions and work together with the Tourism Board. So I direct it to PTC, Mr. Sawyer, please.
Thank you for the question. Questions, I should say, plural. In terms of the waiting area, quite rightly, as you said, we are increasing the capacity to approximately 1,300 people that can wait in temperature-controlled comfort and be entertained. Currently, or previously, maybe I should say, we could fit about 420 people in. But I think the most important aspect is not about how many people can wait, but about the fact that we can now transport so many more people with the 210 in the new tram, that we don't believe there will be very little waiting anyway. So we see no issue in terms of either the lower terminus or the upper terminus at the peak. We believe there will be no queues. Very occasionally on incredibly busy days, hopefully when our tourists come back, there may be some queuing, but it will be nothing like before. And we believe with this, the capacity of the trams to move 210 people every 7 or 8 minutes, we won't see a problem at all. In terms of access, I think the question was access for tour groups. You're right, we've always had specific access points in the entrance and pass ticketing for tour groups, and that will continue. We'll ensure there are fast track lines for both tenants of the peak, for our staff, for monthly ticket holders, and for tours. So there will be a fast track line specifically designated for different passengers. I think I sort of answered the question in terms of standards at the peak, the same as standards at the lower terminus. Clearly, we don't have the same space at the peak tower that we do at the lower terminus. But as I've said, with the capacity of the new trams, we don't see an issue any longer for queues building up outside the building at all. We believe that the supply and demand now situation is that we'll remove that instantly. The comment, I think, was the questions on the old trams, the fifth generation trams. As we showed in the photograph, we removed one tram car, which is two compartments, and they have gone into storage. We are in discussions with a couple of organizations on utilizing those trams for various activities. They've requested confidentiality until they can work out how they're going to deal with them. But we are actively negotiating with a couple of different organizations. The other tram car with the two compartments is parked next to the old green tram car, the 1950s tram car that we retained previously. And that will stay on the next to the track, so as when our passengers go up and down, they can see both the burgundy tram and the old green tram. Thank you.
Any more questions? If not, shall we invite the public for any opinions or comments? If not, then I will move on to the ordinance itself. So can the government take the lead? According to the peak tram amendment regulation 2018, legal notice 171, and for 2021, we appoint 17th of December 2021 as the day on which the regulation comes into operation. So I would brief you on the legislative timeline. It would be for the enactment would be 1st of September 2021, and The deadline for giving notice of motion to amend the subsidiary legislation will be 5 clear days from 25th in August in 2021. The day of reporting to the House Committee would be 20th of August, and I would report orally to the Subcommittee in due course. If not, I will finish this matter. Thank you.